Alright, chat. We're now two games into our pre-season and things are looking relatively shaky in my opinion. You might see this as a positive thing that we have won both of these fixtures, however I do not, and I'm going to explain this to you now. So for those who are unaware, our first pre-season friendly was of course Bamber Bridge, our annual trip to Brigg, and it was a game that we saw success in as we won 7-0. Now, this sounds fantastic on paper, but then some people will say, yeah, it's only Bamber Bridge, but that's not why it sounds fantastic on paper. It sounds fantastic based on the scoreline alone. The fact that it was Bamber Bridge does not take away from the quality of the performances of players. The thing that takes away from the full-time result is the nature on how we won the 7-0 and who scored the goals. And if you are unaware, the first half was 1-0 to us at half-time, and it was an own goal scored by a Brigg player from a set piece. And come the second half, the squad had a rotation, and we took off a majority of the players from the first half, which were first team players, and replaced them with the youth team. And it's safe to say the youth team saw some incredible results in their attacking. Now what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to boot up Preston's website, and we're going to see if it'll tell us the lineup for this match, because I can't remember it off the top of my head. I can't list to, you know, 11 players, but blah, 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 whatever. But all I know is there are a couple of first team players that were on the side to begin with, and I remember one of them, of course, being Woodburn. Let's have a look. So the first half for us, we played Woodman, Diaby, Bauer, Potts, Ledson, Brady and Woodburn from the first team. That's a decent number of first team players. Of course, Woodman put in a great shift as always. Diaby did great, I think. Bauer did quite good, one mishap. Potts did fine enough, Ledson did alright, being the captain and all. Brady did fine as well. Woodburn did... It was a mixed reception for Woodburn for me, because with Woodburn, he was fine on controlling the ball on the pitch and moving it around the pitch, but when it came to the final touch, it was horrendous. He missed three sitters and hit the post once. It was quite bizarre, to be fair. I don't understand how he's missed the shots that he's taken. They've all gone wide. So his finishing was garbage, but everything else was all right, I suppose. So I'll give him the benefit of the doubt in terms of what else he can do. But in terms of playing him up top, that's something we are not allowed to do going forward. Second half, as you can see, we had Story and Lindsay and Cornell being the only first team players that were brought on. And we had, of course, this absolute young, fantastic superstar come onto the pitch as well, scoring a goal. I think he scored two, actually. I can't remember. But yeah, it was a great performance from the youth team, is what I'm trying to say. And now, recently, we've just played an hour ago. We played Bruno's Magpies over in Spain for our pre-season friendly abroad. And what do you know? It's a very similar story. 0-0 at half time. Youth team gets brought on. 3-0 full time. That's what I'm trying to say. Our starting 11 in the first half was Woodman, Story, Lindsay, Potts, Ledson, Brown, Woodburn, Brady from the first team. That's a lot of players from the first team. And in the second half, we had Cornell, Diaby, Bauer, McCann, and that's it. Now, of course, I didn't watch this match, so I don't know how things went, because there was just nowhere to watch it unless you paid to watch it on the Magpies official streaming site, and I refused to do that. So yeah, I could tell you about Brigg because I went to watch Brigg, but I didn't watch this. So let's read, shall we? Following the first half, a few chances. 11 changes were made at the break by North End, and Rodriguez Gentile, who netted against Bamber Bridge last weekend, scored within 6 minutes. He's fantastic. The kid is going to have a bright future. Mwene, after being involved in the opening goal, then scored his side second, but before Taylor made it three soon after with a good finish. Playing at Pinata Arena against the Gibraltar National League outfit, PNE were backed by hundreds of their supporters, with many making the trip up on the day from Benidorm. Northern had the first chance of the game 7 minutes in, when Robbie Brady's free kick was won in the air by Lindsay, and the ball was then struck goalwards by O'Neill, whose effort was kept out by the keeper. At the other end, Woodman had to come up with an important stop himself to deny Jack Story, who had been sent through on goal. The goalkeeper made a simpler save to hold a deflected that guy effort on 21 minutes, while Hankins did well to tip over Brady's 20-yard free kick over the bar shortly afterwards. There was wholesale changes at the break for North End, with 11 altercations made. It took just 6 minutes for Rodriguez Gentile to make an impact. Mwene had done well at the top of the pitch to intercept a Magpies defender, and 16-year-old Philip took a touch before calmly finding the bottom corner. 7 minutes later, the Lily Whites doubled their lead through Mwene, who received a ball with his back to goal, swivelled and expertly found the near bottom corner. I can't wait to see these highlights. It was 3 on 66 minutes when Philippe found Taylor in space approaching the edge of the box, and the lifelong North End fan smashed the ball past Hankins in goal. I can't read today. Lewis Lee almost made it 4 shortly after when he drove towards goal and let a left-footed effort fly just wide of goal, while Mwene also sent a strike inches wrong side of the post late on. So yeah, sweet. Considering the first team couldn't do anything against Bamber Bridge and they couldn't do anything against Bruno's Magpies, and the youth team are putting together something that is looking to be attacking extravaganza, it's concerning because we aren't going to be playing the youth team in the league or in the FA Cup or in the EFL Cup. It's just not going to be happening that way. Well, not entirely anyway. So come August, when we have to travel to Bristol, and then when we're playing Salford and Sunderland and these other teams at home, what the hell are we going to do? Because unless we, you know, can bring forward some signings that actually know how to finish, we are pretty fucked, to put it quite bluntly. Because, like I said, none of the lads can seem to know how to finish, and Ched and Rhys aren't expected back until September. So, by the looks of things, we're either going to have to play the youth team up front, which we should be doing instead of playing Ben Woodburn up front, or just sign 2 strikers. And knowing North End, signing 2 strikers isn't likely. However, according to this Peter Ridsdale thing that went on Saturday at the Brig game, people fancy our chances. Now, as per usual, when it comes to news that I haven't got up on the screen already, we head to Twitter and we head over to either PNE Pure or Thailand Talk, and I believe it was PNE Pure that shared this news, so I'm going to try and find it now. Probably should have brought this up, but there we go. Yeah, I'm pretty sure, I don't know if I mentioned this in the previous video or not, I don't think I did, but if for those that are unaware, there was a bit of an altercation with Ridsdale at the Bamber Bridge game, where he was mouthing off to a fan in the stands, and Craig Hemmings came basically to defuse the situation and speak with the fan. I didn't witness the entire conversation, but I did walk past Peter Ridsdale as he was giving, you know, a bit of mouth to this fan. And at first I thought it was a bit embarrassing because it's your club's chairman giving a lot of shite to an old man sat in the stands. It didn't look great. But when you look more into the situation and that it was provoked, then obviously it's a bit understandable. There's a lot of pressure on the guy, and I'm not defending Ridsdale at all. I'm just saying, when you have that much pressure built on you all the time, it's eventually going to burst, and unfortunately it had to burst at Brig, but that's just it. But anyways, what was overheard from the conversation was that we have one of these strikers is a Dane. Oh, sorry, let me read this part first. We are way along the line with 3 players with offers for 2 more, or offers for 2 of them. One of them is a Dane, one is an under-21 away with his national team, 2 of them are strikers, and 1 is Romanian. There's another we do not have any information on. So, if that's the case, 2 strikers, boom, straight away. But there's this necessarily, it says we're along the line with 3 players and offers in for 2. Does that mean 5 players or does it mean 3? It probably means 5. And I'm just dyslexic and can't count properly or whatever. But it is what it is, like I say. So there's definitely things in the pipeline if this is to be believed. But now that this has been said and the pressure is now on for these players to be signed, and things start to crumble, that's when people are going to start getting back on Ridsdale's back and back on North End's back on Ryan Law's back and Hemmings, and everything's going to go to shit on the social scene again. So you can only take the information with a grain of salt. And at the end of the day, it's not Ridsdale or Hemmings that has come out publicly and said this in an announcement. It's what's been overheard between a conversation between Hemmings, Ridsdale and this fella that was involved with it or whatever else. This is all just, you know, word of mouth and ear. You know what I mean? Like the Bible. It could be false, it could be real, we don't know. There's no proper evidence to support it because no one took a video of it, so there you go. That's all we can tell you about it. So, like I said, plenty of things going on wise in terms of the squad, but is it good that we have these results from pre-season so far? Yes, it's a good start to the pre-season, but at the same time, when the first team is contributing basically none of it, it's not what you want to be seeing, especially when it's the first team that we are going to be going to watch when we go back to Deepdale in just a couple of weeks' time. So I'm very topsy-turvy and a bit like about things at the minute. That was a very strange way of describing how I feel. I feel all over the place about this because, like I said, it's fantastic the youth team are performing. It's fantastic that we can get the youth team up there and playing to a high standard. But it's also quite concerning because the first team can't do it. And when Ryan Law's saying in post-match interviews that he expects his players to play like that, there's trouble. But yeah, that's our pre-season as it has begun so far. So our next fixture, I believe, is Bury on Sunday, which is one I'll be going to and one that I will be enjoying for sure. And the next one after that will be Barrow, which is one that I will not be going to. So yeah, I will probably provide an update on the Bury game on the Monday or Tuesday following. But yeah, until then, if we hear any other news about any like kit news or, you know, signing news, whatever comes first, I'll be sure to keep everyone updated. But thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.